Okay, and yeah, so sorry about last time, we'll just sum it up for you. Basically, he said, I am a robot, army unit, whatever, soldier, robot soldier that, was sent to this island from the surface, to search out and destroy this crown that gives people magical powers, and, that crown is the crown that the doctor is currently wearing. And so, I'm a robot, save the world, I obviously failed in my mission if I'm here and the doctor has the crown, so... And oh look, a person. Come back. No, I want to negotiate terms with you.
So I stop killing you?
Well, yes.
Because you just spent the last 5 videos trying to kill me. For 15 straight minutes.
Well, no, I stopped at 11 most of the time.
And just
I figured you guys didn't want to watch three or four episodes of me failing to beat Curly repeatedly. What was that?
Ooh! We have a visitor! I know what it is you're looking for. But wake up! Mimigas aren't your enemies. Mimigas are harmless. Too bad for you, but I'm on their side. You're going down.
Don't you dare, don't you dare. Yes! That was close. Seriously! I jumped! What the- no, why did I do that? Okay. Once again. I made this joke in one of my previous attempts, but, it's like I'm GLaDOS. I'm reliving the last couple minutes of my life over and over and over. And it's like I can't do anything about it because I keep dying. Maybe talking in King's voice will help me muster up courage. Are you sure about that? Rage! No, definitely not. Rage. Maybe humiliating her. Oh. Ooh. We have a visitor. Blah, blah, blah. I'm hilarious, though. Oh, wow, that was exceedingly close. Don't you dare, don't you dare. Don't you dare, little Omega. Oh wow, I killed him right before he got up. Don't any of you even. Screw it, rocket launcher! Oh, come on! That would explain why I never used the rocket launcher in this fight, though. Come on, come on, come on, yes! Finally, you can come back now. Only took me, a half hour, but...
You win. I can't fight anymore. I suppose you're going to kill all the Mimigas, just like the other robots. Oh? You're with the Mimigas too? That's right, there's nothing bad about
them. Wait, weren't they just hurting me a second ago?
I'm Curly, Curly Brace. When I woke up, I was with these children. I don't have any memories before
that. You've been teaching them brilliantly. Attack anyone that they don't know.
Amnesia, you might say. I was probably a Mimiga butcher just like the other robots. Oh, wow. That polar star of yours is in awful shape. Do you want to trade it for my machine gun?
Of course not.
Really? Well, if you ever change your mind, I'll be here.
I guess you'll never be here again because I'm not changing my mind. Sucks for you. Save!
What the fuck is that?
It's a puppy! You can't see that it's a puppy?
Puppy looks suspicious.
Arf! Now, I'm sure anyone who's played this knows this. Anyone who hasn't, should definitely
know. Are you
gonna
shoot the dog? No, okay.
Okay, so if you open up your... If we'll open up our map systems for a moment, we see there's the room, and the little white dot is me, and there's a secret passage. And where am I? I am somewhere where I can't see myself. There we go, there I am. Yes.
You pervert! Curly's gonna kill you.
Retrieved from behind the wall. Yellow-green panties with a cute little insignia. They have no use.
You're carrying around panties and lipstick? People are gonna think you're some kind of man whore.
I'm a robot, though. I'm simply curious as to what all these objects mean. I am learning things. And yes, the dog is like, arf. Watch out for the sand crocs. If you step on the sand, they'll jump out and bite you. It really hurts, too.
Like sand dial.
You're looking for red flowers? There's an old woman named Jenka who might know about that. Oh, right. If you go see her, you ought to bring along the dog next to the bed. Dog. Dog, you are coming with me.
Obtained dog.
Yes, isn't it the most adorable thing ever? Isn't it? I don't have to talk to the other ones because they don't know anything about them. Oh, right, save. Save because I have a dog now. Doggy! Who's a good dog? Who's a good doggy?
Ethan,
who's a good
dog?
But, it's a good dog.
Just no.
Who's a good doggy? Isn't he adorable? Even if he's like a 18 by 14 sprite or something, probably way less than that, he's still adorable. Yes. It generally isn't. Oh, damn. How did he escape the fireballs?
That because doesn't... he made more of himself.
No, but that one... No, he shouldn't have dodged the fireball. I should have blown him up. Okay, well, that was my sister leaving. And I don't think I need the voice at all in the rest of this episode, so... because I'm pretty sure I can do an old lady voice just fine. Okay, fine. Do you know who Jenka is? She's an old lady with magical powers. And kill that thing. How to get the life capsule? I swear to God, if you can't figure this out on your own, you must be an imbecile. Shoot. Generally, I'll leave one of the blocks there, but there's the life capsule. You must be an idiot to not be able to figure that out on your own, but whatever. Shoot that, and we're good. And, of course I'm not touching the sand. Why would I ever touch the sand? Knowing there's a monster in it that would kill me 6 times over in one hit. That's right, I know exactly how much damage it does. It does 18 damage. Isn't that funny? Maybe it's because I've seen that little 18 damage thing so many times. I'm not going to kill you right now. I'm going to kill you when you're further away from me. Like now. Alright, Pablo, I can do this. I am completely safe. How convenient. I can open up just the right size path for myself. Da-da-da-da-da. And wait for you to leave. Goodbye. I'm so very brilliant. I'm so brilliant. Shoot all these, shoot all those. Bubbler, shoot all those. Shoot a couple down so that I don't hit the ceiling, and I am good to go. Save point, yes. Doggy, 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 doggy. This is one of the very few places that the fireball is genuinely useful, because see all those guys, if you break the blocks, they'll kind of escape, but the fireball doesn't break blocks. So it can just sort of camp out in these little pits and kill things. And generally, I prefer the polar star over the bubbler in areas like this, because it's more precise and not quite as messy, obviously. Kill you, you. And I'm good to go. I will wreck this area and reveal to you if that little save thing wasn't enough, there are 4 hearts here. And now I'm probably going to die, so, yeah. Hello, Misery. Hello, Omega. I'm going to kill you. I see Balrog failed in his duty. You look like quite a fighter. But at this juncture...
Is that a girl?
Does it matter? I'm fine at doing Misery's voice.
But at this juncture, you're proving yourself rather a nuisance.
Fine.
Shall we settle this? There we go.
Do it a little more ominous-ish.
That is my ominous. No, there's no need for me to get involved.
By the way, this is Omega. He is one of the easiest bosses ever. And why he does that. But besides that, he's extremely easy. Bubbler, I need you. Well, at least I saved right up here. Puppy powers activate. Wait, no, the puppy! Did I kill the puppy? No, nobody cares about the puppy. Everybody's fine with the puppy continuing on living. And those things are coming for some. Don't eat them. And don't eat them. Oh crap, I just dropped that. Okay, yeah. That's extremely irksome. Okay. Let's try and kill it all in one shot this time. This is a lot more fail than I usually have, by the way. Please get out. And then you're like, I'm going to kill you! I don't need to kill him. Blah blah blah, Misery. Sister stole the part. I guess that's just one more thing for her to do, so I guess she'll be returning quite often now. Hey, Omega, you should go ahead and die. Yeah, this is another one of those places where the Butler is extremely useful. Also one of those few places where the bubbler might actually run out of ammo without you realizing it. Because there's just so many things to get rid of. It's like, what the heck? Why are there so many things to get rid of? Hey, a rocket launcher. Do you want to help me out? Oh, crap! Why did he jump so early? Okay, hopefully I can beat him in the next 2 minutes. I swear to God, if this turns out with the Balrog fight, I'm going to be extremely annoyed. Because usually I beat him no problem. And you, my little friend, are going to die. I said it, and thus it has been. Why did I do that? Okay. Keep going, keep going, keep going. There's a sand crop in that one, which is why I have to jump into it. Blah blah blah, more misery. I am definitely not going to finish this, so I'm probably going to have to kill myself, actually. Here's the other option, Polar Star. One of what things done. Yeah. Oh hey, perfect timing. That was quite literally perfect timing, actually. Because I have like 10 seconds left and I just beat Omega. Okay, the spell on Sun Suns has been lifted. Okay, perfect timing, I'm going to stop here, goodbye.